Come join and learn the top reasons why you should rehost your SQL Server on Azure Virtual Machines this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined once again by Amit, who's a group program manager on the Azure Data team. Thanks for joining us today again, Amit.
Hey, thanks, Anna. Glad to be back on the show, and it was great to be talking about SQL Server VMs again.
Yeah, and today we're actually going to be talking about some of the top reasons you should rehost your SQL Server on an Azure Virtual Machine. And I'm really interested to learn more about some of the reasons you have for us to move. So what are the reasons that I should rehost to SQL Server on an Azure VM?
Hey, that's a very common question that customers ask us. What's the benefit of hosting SQL Server virtual machines in Azure? I kind of answer that in two parts. One, I'm going to switch over to my slide deck. The first one is essentially the hybrid benefit that we offer. So in this example, you see we actually offer a grace period of 6 months where you can host your SQL Server licenses both on-premises and in Azure. And what that allows you to do is it allows you to plan for the migration, actually execute the migration without having to rebuy your licenses for Azure. And after those 6 months are over, when you're actually running on Azure, we offer a bunch of benefits. In the previous video that we did together, I talked about how SQL Server software assurance benefits helps reduce the cost of running SQL Server and Azure virtual machines. In addition to that, we also offer a host of other benefits that are enabled through the SQL Server infrastructure as a service or the IaaS extension. And once you enable that on any virtual machine that's running SQL Server, you get the ability to easily configure your high availability. You actually have the ability to configure your SQL Server VM for best practices associated with storage configuration. You get security updates for free if you're running SQL Server 2008 and R2. And you also have the ability of configuring and running your SQL Server environment a lot better than writing custom automation. So let's switch over to my Azure portal and let me show you what those features are. So I'm going to quickly switch over to my Azure portal. And so what you see on your screen right now is actually the SQL Server virtual machine view of a SQL Server 2019 Developer Edition deployed on a Windows Server 2019 server. And in this case, I have actually configured the IaaS extension to save time. And if you look at my configuration option, the first thing you will see is the ability for me to actually configure my SQL Server license. So right now, I'm basically pinged by the R. I'm not incurring a license cost. But if I had to incur a license cost, like switch over to Enterprise or Standard Edition, I could switch on to Azure Hybrid Benefit if I have enough SQL Server licenses covered by Software Assurance that I'm not using on-premises. I even have the ability, if I am a Software Assurance customer or a subscription customer, I can leverage the Disaster Recovery tab to not pay for Disaster Recovery VM. I can easily configure and extend my drive. So the bottom half that you see here, it allows me to extend my drive. It allows me to configure my SQL Server data log and tempdb. And at the same time, when I go over to the security tab, it allows me to configure my SQL Server connectivity for it to be inside the VM, allow it access publicly over the internet, or just within a virtual network. I can set the port. In this case, it's using the default port. If you're running a production VM, you'd want to change this to a non-default port. You can enable mixed mode authentication directly from the portal, and you can also enable Azure Key Vault integration. And this allows you to leverage Key Vault for things like storage encryption at rest with transparent database encryption, or you can use Azure Key Vault keys to encrypt your columns and other data, sensitive data stored inside the SQL Server database. In terms of patching, a lot of our enterprise customers have very sophisticated patching mechanisms that they already deploy. But if you have dev edition VMs that you want to just set up a quick way of patching them with the latest security updates. You can configure a maintenance schedule. You can pick what time it starts and for what duration it has to run. In addition to that, for the same dev VMs, you might want to back them up. You can enable automatic backup, set a retention period, select a storage account, select encryption for the backups, enable system database backups if you want to restore them, and also set up a schedule if you don't want it to be automatic and managed by the automated backup feature of SQL Server. In addition to that, there are a few other features, like, for example, if you're using machine learning, in my case, I have R services enabled. You have the ability to enable it directly and configure it in the portal without you having to go through all the steps. The new feature, which is in preview that I'm super excited about, is the ability for you to configure an availability group or a failover cluster. Once you kick off this wizard, in this case, it's a single node VM, so which is not active, but if you have a cluster, you have the ability to walk through a wizard, which walks you through all the steps of setting up the replicas, configuring the listener, and making sure that it's set up correctly as per SQL Server best practices on Azure. So this actually helps you not just set it up and monitor it. So if you're creating a new SQL Server VM, you have the ability to doing all these tasks up front and making your life a lot easier. So if you go to the configuration tab, the reason why you see the storage configuration here is because I picked the SQL Server IaaS extension when I was setting up this VM. If I look at the overview, you will see all the other capabilities show up nicely in different tiles, and you can click on each one of them and configure them. And at the same time, you can access all of this from the command line or PowerShell as well. So if you have wide-scale automation that you want to drive, you can do that from the command line or any other form of automation that you use to run SQL Server virtual machines on Azure.
Sure. Thanks, Amit. This is really cool. Two things that really stood out to me. One, I wasn't aware of the Azure hybrid benefit that you could get that 6 month of overlap time as you migrate to the cloud. So that's pretty cool. And two, this ability to easily create availability groups and failover cluster instances, like, that's huge. Setting those things up can be a little complicated. So thanks for sharing that with us. You know, if our users want to get started, where do you recommend they start?
Yeah, so I would recommend them to go to aka.ms/AzureSQLVM. That would be a great starting point to look at what features I just demoed on the web. And at the same time, it will also give you an idea of what's upcoming and anything new that we announced for SQL VMs in Azure.
Awesome. Well, thanks again, Amit, for being on the show. I think we're going to shoot one more episode, so be sure to stay tuned, and we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.